The application already contains a crosstab and two buttons for navigation and sorting. Enable navigation for the crosstab. Note that the crosstab now has nodes to expand or collapse hierarchies from the data source. Next, activate the Sorting Enabled property. Sorting buttons now appear on the column headers. Next, run the application locally to test the interactive features added to the crosstab. Use the Hierarchy Navigation nodes to expand and collapse the hierarchies in the Region column. Next, test the sorting feature. Note that navigation and sorting were activated through properties for the crosstab. You can also set the same interactive properties through scripting. Deactivate user interactivity on the properties panel, and then activate it again using scripts. The application contains two buttons with on-click event scripts for user interactivity. Review the script for the navigation button. Note that in this tutorial, the event script is provided for you. The setHierarchyNavigationEnabled method specifies if hierarchies can be expanded or collapsed in the crosstab, and the isHierarchyNavigationEnabled method returns whether hierarchy navigation is enabled or not, meaning that the script creates a toggle feature. When the user clicks the button, it enables hierarchy navigation when it is disabled and disables it when it is enabled. Next, review the script for the sort button. The setSortingEnabled method specifies if sorting is enabled in the crosstab, and the isSortingEnabled method returns whether sorting is enabled or not. As with the navigation button, this creates a toggle feature. When the user clicks the button, it enables sorting when it is disabled and disables it when it is enabled. Test the scripts. First, test navigation. Now test sorting. You have successfully added navigation and sorting features to a crosstab using both user interactivity properties and scripts. This is the end of the tutorial.